$70 million. That's how much the NCAA has agreed to in a preliminary settlement for a class action head injury lawsuit. It's been a long time coming for the thousands of former and current college athletes who have suffered brain injuries from contact sports.
Well, I think anything that you can do to make the game safer and a better game is certainly a positive thing. And what this settlement does is it provides funds for education, research, and testing that are all for the benefit of the student athlete.
It applies to men and women who have played in the last 50 years at any one of the 1,000 accredited NCAA schools. Many colleges already have standards in place. This settlement requires all athletes take baseline neurological tests at the beginning of each year, concussion education for both the coaches and the players, and a new medical committee to oversee the testing. The recovery is no joke.
So the short-term symptoms of a concussion are disorientation, balance problems, memory issues, sometimes emotional lability or flying off the handle after a very minor event or being very emotional. Typically, patients will have headaches.
And if another injury happens too soon after the first, long-term effects can be devastating. Up until now, returning an athlete to play after they've had a blow to the head has been left up to each college to decide. But this settlement requires a uniform protocol they'll all have to follow. Chuck Whedon oversees sports medicine for the athletics department at Monmouth University. He's seen his share of head injuries and knows what teams are up against.
Every kid wants to continue playing. They're all invincible, especially at this age, and they really don't know, and more importantly, they don't care about the consequences.
He supports the reform, but says it's not so simple.
When you mandate a return protocol and you make it too stringent, you open yourself up to individuals questioning any deviation either way.
Here's what the deal doesn't do. Set aside money to pay players who've suffered the brain trauma, much like the NFL suit, to pay for the often expensive and extensive therapy that follows.
I think, you know, what we're seeing today and in recent years is a much heightened awareness to concussions, the symptoms that they project, and there's a greater attention given to them now than there was maybe 40 or 50 years ago.
But before any of this can happen, a U.S. district judge must give preliminary approval, which could take months, and then wait for affected athletes to weigh in before signing off. In Monmouth County, I'm Brianna Venosi, NJTV News.
Brianna Venosi knows firsthand how serious brain injury can be. More than 2 years ago, she was hit by a taxi. She is just now getting back to work and talking for the first time about her experience. Brianna, at the time, did you have any idea how serious your injury was?
I knew it was bad because the symptoms were pretty severe, but it actually took a little bit of time for the severity of the symptoms to set in, and oftentimes you want to push forward, go back to work, get back to life, because you also don't want to accept that it's a pretty life-changing injury. It can be a life-changing
symptoms,
injury.
Symptoms, headaches, dizziness, what?
Vertigo, nausea, confusion, extreme light and sound sensitivity. Every conversation was like a tennis match, sound filtering, not being able to decipher what conversation is coming from where.
I know that doctors and coaches, in conjunction with doctors, can clear a kid with a concussion after 4 weeks.
In some cases, in 4 weeks, a minor head injury, especially if it's the first one, you are okay. And as I spoke to folks today, a lot of times, the younger you are, the faster you heal. But it takes the brain a long time to heal. Even after symptoms aren't physically presenting themselves, your brain is still healing, your body is still healing, and it takes time to do that.
And the danger of secondary impact concussion, those can kill you.
You're much more susceptible, as with any injury on your body, the second time you injure it, you're much more susceptible for it to be much more severe. But your brain controls everything in your body. Not giving it that time to heal can be very detrimental.
We are really glad you're back at work, Brianna. Thank you very much.